When you are walking, or whatever you are doing, I want you to realize something. You are working for yourself. This thing I'm telling you, I want you to internalize it. So people work in offices and they think their bosses are wicked. They think they are not getting good pay. They think others have been promoted, they have not been promoted. You know, all kinds of excuses. And then you just slow down. You don't want to put in your best. This wicked money. You are stealing time in the office, the time should be that should have been spent working and being productive. You are stealing it, watching not football. It's football, that's good. Yeah. You know, you're on the internet reading the emails and doing Facebook and all that. Because you know not my boss. He doesn't deserve it. Everybody is working for himself. That is my first point. Why do I say everybody is working for himself? When they are going to poach, if Accenture is going to poach you, it's not, they don't poach lazy people. You have worked, somebody has observed you. Somebody has seen how you are being diligent, even when your pay is nothing. And he has made a recommendation. This woman called Dora Akunyele, she was working in PTF, the Petroleum Trust Fund, in Enugu office. She had a medical challenge and she traveled. She was entitled to foreign treatment. I don't know how it got into the ears of General Muhammadu Buhari, who was the chairman of PTF at that time. And that's how he mapped that out. When Obasanjo was looking for the director general for NAFDAC, somebody recommended her. And look at what she later made of her life. If she wanted to do it the way everybody was doing it, perhaps she won't get that kind of recommendation. So ultimately, think about yourself. Your boss that you are currently with, or that you are very bitter about, yes, I think it's the boss. He's not trying to prove anything again. He has a company, he's counting his billions, he has his house, he's in London and US. You are the one that needs to make progress with your life. So you are working for yourself, you are not working for your boss. Anything you do, do it diligently. Do it with all diligence. You need to see these Hausa guys who sell Kola Nut and Chungo. Just observe them. He wakes up 7 a.m., he sweeps the road. Maybe the entire world is not worth more than 1,000 naira. Arranges everything with dignity, he's happy. He's doing it diligently. So whatever we do, we must do it diligently. Somebody is watching you. Two, follow your passion. Follow your passion. There is this footballer, Ronaldinho, when he was in the height of his glory. He would be dribbling, he would be beating 2, 3, 4 players, and then somebody will hack him down. And he would just laugh, he would just shake his head. And so he was interviewed, I don't have the exact words, and he was saying that he enjoys football, that this is what he wants to do for money to give him, and on top of everything, he gets paid for it. So we are getting people. If you have a passion, many of us, we are so obsessed with what we study in school, and we forget that we have other skills. Does anybody know T.Y. Bello? T.Y. Bello studied economics at the University of Lagos. She didn't study music, she didn't study photography. But she had a passion for photography. Of course, she was part of a group called Kush, and they were a success, but she still had that passion for the camera. And she invested so much of her resources into buying the latest camera, into training herself. Today, T.Y. Bello is the official photographer of the president of Nigeria. And you know that that's not take about 20,000 naira. It's not even 100,000 and so many other governors, so many governors. She's the official photographer. I know that from the front. Strive to stand out. Don't do the ordinary, do the extraordinary. You've had consultants, you've had MDs, everybody speaking about what they look for in people. People just want to do things the way. Now, I want to launch a website in November, a news website. And when I went to the guy who was going to design it, he just gave me the normal design that he was saying in every news site. This is the size of the advantage. I said, no, this is not what I want. That if I want to do exactly what is on ground, then why should people come to my website? If I want to do a paper that is going to be exactly like Guardian, why should people buy my paper? They already used to buy Guardian. If it's only if I have something extra to offer that will persuade them to buy. So we must strive to be extraordinary. The people who get celebrated in the genuine sense of celebration are those who went the extra mile. And it doesn't matter what you're doing. People are here, you have a mechanic, it doesn't matter. You can decide that you won't be using speed to test if the valve is sticking. Because how many of you want you take your car there and after it has pumped that? You don't want it, so you can decide. Whatever, there's nothing, there's no limit to which you can go. Anything you do, strive to be extraordinary. Those who get celebrated, I repeat, are those who go the extra mile. There's a difference between that man and those men. Strive to stand out. It takes a lot. It takes a lot. Before, when I was in the university, I used to go, I decided then that, see, I was going to be writing sport. I used to go, anytime I was free at the University of Lagos, I would go to the National Library, I would go and collect newspapers of 1920-something, 1940-something, Daily Times, all kinds of papers. I would be reading all the match reports. I had a notebook on my side. I would be taking notes. Who was in goal? Who scored for Nigeria? What minute did this goal? What red card? And I was writing all those down. When I started my journalism career, I started writing sport. People, where did he get this back from? But it took me years to connect those facts. And so any match, if I want to cover a football match there, any report I wrote, they always saw a difference. Because I went the extra. It was not convenient. I will leave you that then and go all the way to, well, not to Fayama, but I will be in the library from morning to evening. Sometimes I won't eat until like 4 o'clock. He was talking about how other countries are moving and we are just backward. We don't have a strategy. We don't have a strategy. The countries that are moving ahead today, they sat down, there was a strategy. The Dubai, all of us are worshipping today. Dubai is a story of 20 years. I've not already told you that on the 7th day God created Dubai. Dubai was created by human beings. Dubai was created by people like you. They sat down, structural engineers, bankers, they sat down and drew a map and said, this is what we want. We are going to deal with trade, we deal with tourism, we deal with this and that. That was how Dubai started. What led to Dubai? Beirut, Lebanon, used to be the same capital for the Arabs. That was when they were drinking their wine and sleeping with women and all those things. But when war broke out in Beirut, see, Dubai doesn't look. I hope you know that Dubai is an emirate. When you hear emirate, that's an Islamic system. That's what they wrote. People won't go to Beirut again. That's how they relax their orders. United Arab Emirates is made up of 7 emirates. Dubai is just one of them. There's Abu Dhabi and so many other. So the Dubai guy just said, look, we have to relax the orders a bit. And that's how they relax the orders. I started building. And Nigerians are flocking to Dubai now. It's to human beings like them that built it. Because they had a strategy. The Chinese, they have a strategy. When they say they are building roads for you, they are going somewhere. They are trying to displace America, the West. Because they were not bad off from the beginning, but they just kept to themselves. When the West went out and started colonizing, started doing expedition, taking over Africa, taking South America, they kept to themselves. Now they are trying to reverse it. And that's why they are very aggressive. It's not ordinary. It's not as if they just say, okay, let's just go to Nigeria. There is a plan, there is a master plan. There's somewhere they are going to. That's why they want to do it. They say, we'll do it for you. We want to build a plan, okay, we'll do it for you. And most of this is funded by the government. could be strategic. When you hear World Bank and IMF say, Africa is the fastest growing economy, fastest growing region in the world, it's because it fits into their own narrative. What they want is a market. What they want is a market. So you have Africans, Nigeria mobile for 120 million. Not one is assembled in Nigeria. They're not strategic. They're not strategic. So Africans will have 600 million mobile phones in Africa. More than what they have in the United States. Yet, not one is manufactured there because you are not strategic. So, in your career, you have to be strategic in your plan. If you are going somewhere, if you decide what you want to be, you have to start saying, your person is, where am I going? How am I going to get there? What are the steps for me to get there? What are the things I need to do? Do I need to go to school? Do I need to work in a particular place? Do I need to do this and that? That is how, when you have that, you are thinking ahead. That's when everything you are doing now makes sense, which is exactly what I was talking about. Purpose. That's why it makes sense. You're not just waking up and sleeping. You're eating, sleeping, going to work up. Many Africans, that's what we do, just wake up, go to work up, and we don't know that we live in an environment. We don't know we are living in a world that is, you know, when you say globalization, what is the role of Africa in globalization? What is our contribution? I'm just a market. I just consume. I'm just a market. I'm not producing, I'm not selling. We sell crude to them at $100 per barrel. By the time they bring everything back, they are making $2,000. I decide to go back to you, buy the insecticide, buy the engine oil, buy the petrol. If I'm very good to buy petrol, you are buying everything from the plastic. So we must look at individually. How do we fit into